bow prayer. Father, we thank thee for this occasion. We thank you that this is the beginning of the life of many of those who have graduated. We thank you, Lord, it's the beginning that will mean sometimes struggle, but yet, Lord, they'll be strong and they'll be overcome. We thank you for the parents that have come, that have gave their time, money, and energy to help these students to come to this place in their lives. We also thank you for those who have taken hours of their lives to teach, to comfort, to strengthen, to help these students to get to this place at this time. And now, Lord, we ask for faith, we ask for love, for these students as they go out into a challenging world. We ask, Lord, that you let them know that they are able to conquer if they have faith in you and in themselves. We pray that their lives be great lives and lives which will be shared with others. For these things we thank you in Jesus' name.
We, the class of 1987, graduate from Bridgeton High School, we leave behind good friends, good times, and thank God, school lunches. But we take with us an education, memories, indigestion, and a dream to make an independent life for ourselves. We now begin this dream as individuals, not groups, in a world filled with new friends, new memories, and new dreams. We may be a little afraid of what lies ahead of us, but remember way back in eighth grade when we were scared to death to walk the halls of BHS? Well, that was one long year, but we made it. And in ninth grade, when all those new faces entered our school, those new faces from the sending districts and private schools not only entered our school, but also walked right into our lives by becoming our good friends. By 10th grade, we were making a dent in Bridgeton High. We were now no longer the babies. We were being recognized by teachers, coaches, upper and underclassmen. The only regret was, by the time all the recognizing was through, we moved into 11th grade. Juniors, boy, did that have a nice sound. Sure, we were officially recognized by the school, and sure, we were studying hard, but with the title juniors, we had to accept the responsibility to have fun, to not mention school on a Friday and Saturday night, and most important, to remember only one more year. Now this year is almost through. Senior, that's the best title you can give a student. We have just reached one ledge in our climb to the peak. This ledge is a goal within our grasp that we could not have reached without standing on the shoulders of special people who pushed us up. Our parents, teachers, coaches, and friends deserve a special thanks. Without them, we would not have this great chance to succeed. This dream of ours to graduate is now becoming a reality. This leaves us room for yet another dream. Each of us will strive to turn these new dreams into accomplishments. Yes, today's dreams are tomorrow's reality. We are finally here. This is the year we have been waiting for 12 years. This is the year we have looked forward to, our senior year. Prom, graduation, friends, family. But it's much more than that. We have found that being a senior also means triumph, failure, decision, and goodbye. Throughout our lives, we have strived to be the best we can be. It did not matter how tough the opposition or how great the talent. We responded with our best effort. No obstacle was too big or mountain too high. For many of us, this year has brought many triumphs. No one would ever forget the year of the Bulldogs. This was the year our cross-country, football, and basketball team overcame many obstacles and triumphs, proving not only to the city, but also to themselves that
they are number one. No matter how small our personal triumphs seemed to others, we knew how important they were and how hard we had to work to achieve them. Each of us, during the course of this year, has proven to our families, our friends, our teachers, and our churches who we are and what we will become. But we also learned about life. We fail at success is often paired with failure. Failure does hurt, but we conquered it and kept on going. We did not want others to know how much we hurt, and only our family and closest friends were able to let us see life's silver lining. Being a senior also means making decisions. Throughout our lives, we have relied on our parents and guardians to make our decisions and steer our lives in the right direction. But now we are on our own. We have had to make decisions that will ultimately decide the course our future will take. We know what we want in life, but we will let nothing stand in the way of accomplishing our goals. Success is a peace of mind, which is a direct result of self-satisfaction and knowing you did your best to become the best that you are capable of becoming. The hardest part of all is goodbye. We will soon be going our separate ways and will have to leave our loved ones behind. As we look around us tonight to see our friends, we have known each other for the most part, only 4 years. But the friendships we have made here will last a lifetime. We have had good times, we have shared bad times. We have learned that we can laugh together. We have found that we can speak together, both with words and without them. But most importantly, we have learned who we are through our friends. We are about to embark on a new beginning. We will make new friends, live new lives, and fulfill all of our dreams. Memories will prevail, and so we must say goodbye and move on. We will never forget the todays and the yesterdays, or those who have played major roles in making us who we are. May we always remember these times and these people. Wherever we go, whatever we become, we will always know that these people that make up the class of 1987 will be our friends